All right, well, I'll stop talking for a bit now and let you guys have a crack at creating mesh, creating mesh variables, setting values in those mesh variables, and having a crack at actually modifying the mesh itself. I want to have a try at doing some sort of node bunching, shuffling vertices up to the top of the domain where you typically want your resolution to be. So maybe we'll see how you go. Let's go through to 10 on this exercise, and I'll wander around and see how you guys are going with it. How do we all go with that? Did anyone get all of that done? Someone? Did you manage to get a unit circle rendered? Anyone not manage to get this far? So all I've done is created a mesh. I've just, in this case, started from -1, -1 through to 1, 1. That's just for convenience, just easier to do that than having to offset your test for whether it's inside the circle or not. And here I just construct a just little test, which just checks what's the distance from the center, effectively. And so I initially set the data to 0, just, you don't have to do that usually, but it's often a good idea just to initialize your data to whatever you wanted to. Now, note for those not particularly familiar with the NumPy syntax, if you just hit a colon there, it basically just grabs everything in that array and then you can assign it accordingly. So I just test if it's the radius from the center, distance from the center, and then if it's within that unit circle, then we just set the value to 1 there. And yeah. For the deep formation stage, I've just used this hyperbolic tan function. I mean, it's kind of just a somewhat arbitrary mesh deformation we've gone with here, but it's more just an exercise getting you used to using that with deform handle to have at the actual mesh data itself. Are there any questions on that?